Now, if you guys remember, maybe you don't, last commentary, or a previous commentary, I told you guys about Linville Joseph and how I spot started him. Now, take a look, 90 block shed, 87 power move at a defensive tackle position with a 93 strength is not too bad. Also, I have the man himself, Clinton Dix. Yo, it's going to be a laughing matter how nasty this guy is. Like, he's better than my Charles Woodson. Like, that was kind of disappointing to me, but it's all good in the Southside hood. As you guys see, love his attributes. More athletic also with the same zone coverage. So let's hop into the game, man. I love returning kicks with Marquise Goodwin, and he's bouncing this one to the outside juke. So we start off first and 10. Killer Cam manning the gun. Dropping back, Cam Newton. And I almost throw a pick my first play. Now, going to tell you guys, this game was pretty rough. It's Cam. I relentlessly, you know, just kind of scrambled on that play. So here we go again. Cam. I don't know why that guy just stopped. I threw it up to Jimmy. It clanks off of Jimmy's hand. And that was a little bit annoying. It was like Jimmy on like a 6-1 corner. That pass was not to who you think it was to. Go back. I threw that to Triangle. That was just a terrible ball from Cam. And again, another bad throw, a bad decision on my behalf, and we go 3-and-out to start off the game. So this guy, he has Marshawn Lynch. He's a Seahawks fan. He's going to try to kill me on the ground. To put things, you know, in plain terms, he hops over the line that play. 1st and 10, 1:10 left. He goes to the precision pass, low comeback route, or a hitch, whatever. So, he's dropping back. I'm looking to make a play. Cushing. Can't catch the interception. 2nd and 10. I take away that slant, and we come down with the sack. Linville Joseph, the guys I told you who I spot started, already making his presence felt. And just like that, we get the ball right back. I told you guys, I love returning kicks with Marquise Goodwin. Punts, whatever. Marquise Goodwin. That play, 21 might want to take a seat on the bench. That was my fault, though. So, Forte. Spin move. Forte. Juke move. I love the way this Forte guy runs, man. He's a beast. I can't front. Forte back up the middle. Shout out Shy City, man. Big comeback last week. Cam Newton all day in the pocket. I check down to Forte. This guy is leaving the underneath passes open. Forte on the screen. You know, it's kind of a dink and dunk offense right now. We got to get the ball moving. Cam isn't making the throws I want him to make. So, Danny Woodhead. I honestly don't know why Woodhead was in on that play. Because Forte, that's like a 90-something stamina, is on 3rd and 3. Just a bull to bring down Forte yet again. And yeah, hey, why not back to Forte? Spin move, coasting into the end zone. It's Matthew Forte. So 4th and 10, 5 seconds left before the second half, or the first half ends. Launches it deep. I was actually like in punt formation. I thought the guy was going to punt it. I wanted another kick return, punt return. You know, Lavonte David. My God, dropping the pick. This time I manned up. I was beat. Hope to see some man Sunday from the Saints. Marshawn up the middle. If Stanley Baptiste is active, I would be so happy. Oh my gosh, it would be amazing. As this guy's not giving up on the run game. This was a great pursuit from Brian Cushing. I need to tighten things up. He runs the screenplay and screens. I hate defending them. Great spin move from Marshawn. Now it's the 3rd quarter. It's 0-7. It's 3rd and 6. I read the screen. But yo, tell me how that's not a pick. Like, I was right there. Just let me have the pick. Runs the hitch, comeback, whatever, again. And he's inside my 20. He's knocking on the door. Great tackle right there from Sean Lee. Playing him out of position at the outside linebacker in 4-3. More so for his coverage and his instincts. That play, I felt like I really could have had an interception. So I think that's Cushing shoots the wrong gap. Marshawn Lynch punches it in for the touchdown. Now, first play, Cam gets hit. He delivers a beautiful pass to T.Y. Hilton, who adjusts beautifully for the ball. Cam Newton, I thought that was a play action. We go to Forte, playing conservative. Now, this play, Cam Newton, no play action, just dropping back. I thought Jimmy would be able to get me a little more on that play. So, it's 4th and 6. This could be the game. I'm calling an audible play action. Cam. Cam It's my fault. We didn't complete the pass. He gets a shot to win the game. He launches it deep on the Hail Mary. Now, you guys know that they catch a lot of those passes where you drop it. Like, it's more prevalent in this year's Mutt. If I would have lost on that, I'd be done with Mutt commentaries for a while. Third and 10, I throw it up to Jimmy. You 6'7". You Jimmy the Beast. Like, he just comes down with it. Back to Danny Woodhead. Now, I want you guys to pay close attention to the man, Jimmy Graham, running right down the middle for the touchdown in overtime. We come away with the victory. Jimmy Graham, love that guy, dude. We come away with the win. It just couldn't be a more fitting victory to have Jimmy Graham put the team on his back in overtime. Hope you guys enjoyed the commentary, man. A lot more coming out soon. I'm D-Coop. I'm out. One of my favorite Mutt traditions, man, it's Legends Weekend, and we have a lot of packs in front of us. We're actually going to pull a good bit. Now, I wanted to pull a Legends pack.